scoring the action, star referee Steve Gray. Introducing our first boxer, boxing out of the blue corner and wearing the blue shorts trimmed with white. He weighed in 10 stone, 10 pounds and 5 ounces. Taking part in his 25th contest as a professional, from Clash Champion, Ukraine, Mikhailo Santos! And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome his opponent facing him across the ring and boxing out of the red corner. Wearing the dark blue shorts and weighing in at 10 stone, 11 pounds and 3 ounces. He comes to the ring with a perfect professional record. 9 wins from 9 contests from Rochdale, the Diabetic Kid, Muhammad Ali!
Okay, A-star referee Steve Gray will give the final instructions. The Diabetic Kid, Muhammad Ali, 9-9. He's in there against Mikhailo Santos. I'm Aki Karim. I am joined by Stephen Swifty Smith and Jack Bateson. And guys, it's been a really good show so far. And we're now into like the big boys. We've got Muhammad Ali, Jack Raff, Mark Jeffers, Liam Taylor. Don't go anywhere if you're joining us. You enjoying the evening so far, lads?
Really am, yeah. I think it's been a great card so far, you know. All the away fighters have come to win, and it's making some entertaining fights for sure.
Same, yeah. It's been some really good value in the fights. It's always good to see the opponent come to win, you know, come to fight. And we've had that tonight. You know, we've had an away win early on the show, and all the rest have come and really put themselves, you know, in contention to win the fight. So it's been good going into this, and this looks like it started off the way. Yeah. Way the rest
I was just going to say that it doesn't look like we're going to get anything different here. Santos is coming in here. He looks really bulky and compact sort of fighter. You think he's got Pitbull on the back of his shorts, so that might tell us a bit about where he's coming from. And
I think that nickname looks down to a T for what we've seen so far.
Yeah, it's very apt, isn't it? I think maybe, you know, these opponents, they have a look. They maybe just have a little look on Boxrec, see the opposition, the fighting, and how they're looking. And I think with the Diabetic Kid, Muhammad Ali, I think he's 9-0, but he hasn't had no knockout. So I think he's coming to this fight thinking, you know what, I'll back him up and I'll see what he's got. And it looks like he's starting off that way. He just looks like he's got his hands on his chin, he's moving his head, and he's trying to unload himself.
Well, he's got good waist movement as well, and it could be a good testing encounter this for Muhammad Ali, who boxes out of, well, famous gym in Manchester Salford, Oliver's gym, and Humphrey Harrison and Tom over there.
He's using that jab well. I think he just needs to earn a little bit more respect, you know, put a few power shots in there and give the man known as Pitbull a reason not to try and march forward, which he's just done. And you know what, it's a bit better this from Ali.
Yeah, it was a bit of I wouldn't say a torrid start at all, but he definitely was had to think about it, and this is a little bit better from him because he's putting some shots together and he's trying to just land, just touch him and just make him think a little bit.
Yeah, when you've got a man that's showing you no respect, he's just trying to walk you down, he's literally dipping his head and unloading himself, so it's going to be a long night unless you make a dent in him and you know, you earn his respect, so you've got to let a couple of power shots know and let them go and let him know that, listen, you can't walk me down. If you do, you're going to get hit.
Yeah. I think he has caught him with one about 30 seconds ago, and it's made him think a little bit more coming in, but he's still coming.
He's still coming, yeah.
You know what, Ali lands a good body shot then, and I think that might be a little bit of a key to success. I know he's got a good height advantage, but when he's unloading like this, if you can sink one in downstairs, it'll make him think twice about doing it again.
He's definitely getting through with a bit more, and he's had bloodied the nose as well of Santos, but Santos is coming back at the end of the round.
Good round.
Yeah, good round. I've got a feeling this could warm into an entertaining little scrap.
Definitely so. I think Ali knows he's in a fight.
Humphrey Harrison there with him in the corner, of course, brother of the late Oliver Harrison. who of course well respected in the boxing community, and he's carrying the gym on with Tom. Loads of peak fighters who probably could even be watching tonight have come through that gym. Top gym.
He's left a legacy behind him, Oliver, and we've got Jamie Moore now trying to carry on in his footsteps and push some top fighters through. He's an amazing man, Oliver Harrison, and he had some great works in that gym and brought some top fighters through.
We go into round number two. Diabetic kid Muhammad Ali is in the ring now against Makilio Suvtas. We're live on BBTV. Thank you for joining us. Four fights left, guys. Muhammad Ali, Jack Rafferty, Mark Jeffers, and Liam Taylor. So you don't want to go anywhere.
Tell you what, Jack, them right hooks are coming from the floor, aren't they?
He's probably come to have a go, hasn't he? And like we were saying before, it's making for an entertaining fight. And Muhammad Ali, he's got to be on point now. He's got to take control again because he started fast in this round with Softus.
Yeah, it's a tough night. If he can keep this pace up,
yeah,
it's going to be a really tough night for Muhammad Ali. And he's going to have to, as you said before, make a dent in him because he's just relentless at the minute.
Yeah. He just needs to get back on that jab now. You know, he was using the jab well in the first round. If he can get behind that jab again.
Yeah, again, jab. Faint jab again. And then, yeah, and then pick your power shots where they're landing. You're not just wasting energy, but,
yeah,
you know, a bit more precise. And then every power shot you land, let him know. Make a dent where he's got to think twice about just walking him down.
Yeah. You mentioned that body shot in the first round. Yeah. If you can land another one of them and...
Yeah, that could be the way to stop him off a little bit, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Yeah.
Just try the body shot himself, though, so I think he's still coming for it. Yeah.
It seems in this round, Muhammad Ali to be going a lot more bent arm with him.
Yeah. I think he's thinking, I've got to win his respect, isn't he?
I think he's trying to do that, but, you know, This is a strong man who he's fighting, and I think it's wrong to be going bent arm with him. But he needs to get back behind that jab and stick a few straight right hands in that are strong.
If you've got a height advantage, then you know it's obviously best you use it.
Yeah.
And the shorter man will be happy that he's throwing bent arm shots because that's more his range and where he wants to fight. So I don't think the fans are going to be arguing with it, though.
It's looking
it's exciting, mate.
It is.
Oh, lovely right hand.
You know what it is? He's having good success in close. I think he's just making the night hard for himself, but he might be happier doing that, to be fair. But he's catching him again with some nice short shots.
Yeah, I think when he spent the first round on his back foot and trying to outbox him, and I think he felt that his opponent was getting to him too easy, so he's thought, you know what, I'm going to change it up. And every credit to him for doing that.
Exactly, yeah.
But he's gone out and he's thought, you know what, it wasn't working boxing, I'm going to have a fight. And
He's won the round for me as well, so it's, that might be the way it's going now.
Yeah, good on him. Listen, it's probably not the best tactics, but I give him, go out and have a fight. But it wasn't working boxing, so he's thought, you know what, I'll fight him. And good on him.
Guys, thank you for joining us. If you are on the live stream, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Plenty more small oil boxing coming in the next few months on BBTV. And we're very grateful that you're tuning in tonight. Next up, for the Jack Rafferty fans, he's back after a year out of the ring with injury. After that, we'll have Mark Jeffers, who's back in the ring from a little spell out from Chorley, he is, and then Liam Taylor in the main event. Round number three here in Bolton. Muhammad Ali, the diabetic kid, against Makilio Suvtas.
Straight out with the bombs again is Suvtas. Yeah.
The boat lands and flush. I think one of them's going to make a dent soon. Soft has tried the right hand round the side twice,
yeah.
Didn't he?
Yeah.
He had success the first one, and you've seen that he went for
yeah.
it again.
Yeah.
You mentioned before, but I think he needs to get that jab working now, Ali, and try and create a bit of distance.
I was just going to say, I'd just love to see a few more jabs. You know, he's doing a lot of nice work inside, but it's very tip-tat inside. If you can throw a few jabs in between, it just creates that gap.
Oh, that's a good little uppercut there he landed.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, they're both swinging now, aren't they?
Yeah.
Nice right hands.
Some good flush shots going in from both men here.
This is where mixing his jab up will create a bit more space. Yep. And you don't want to be there in that range because it looks more suited to his opponent at the minute.
It's sometimes tempting to get drawn into their fight, isn't it?
Yeah, if you're the up-and-coming prospect and you're 11-0, you don't want to be having a toss-up with a fighter, you know what I mean? If the boat's standing range swinging, then, you know, you may as well toss a coin who's going to land because it's leaving it to chance. Whereas if he lets the skill set take over and he uses the jab, as Jack was saying, you know, mix your jab up, create a bit more distance where you've got the room to showcase your talent and use your skills, I'd have my money on Amdali then. But the way the fight at the minute, and it's a shootout, then it's whoever lands, you may as well toss a coin.
As the round goes deeper in, Softus looks to get a little bit more tired. I think he starts quite fast early, but he seems to fade a little bit. Saying that, he's coming on a bit strong here, but like we said before, we just like to see Muhammad Ali just get that back behind the jab. When he throws them straight shots, just like he did there, and gets on the move, it's nice work, and he's going to pick up the rounds by doing that.
Well, we're starting getting some good competitive fights, and that is what we want to see. I think that's the essence of small or boxing, but you're right, he doesn't want to get dragged in. Because this Softus, he looks like he does have some power himself, especially when he rolls a short right hand over the top.
Yeah, he's a little unit, isn't he?
Yeah, he's built
he is a unit,
way,
yeah.
Yeah, he's built strong.
He's thrown some of these with bad intentions as well.
See the little pauses there where there's a bit of a gap. I'd like to see Muhammad just bang the jab out, mix it up. Little feint, throw a jab again and just snap it out, just keep the distance between the two of them. Yeah, he's just done it to the body then, but he's had a lot of opportunities to do that.
Yeah, this of course is a six rounder. Shaping up into a nice fight.
Yeah, it's good to watch, and again, I know we keep harping on about it, but Muhammad can jab, can keep the distance, and you don't have to become unpredictable by jabbing. You can mix your jab up, you can do a fast jab, a power jab, and keep your opponent thinking with it, but while also, you know, keeping the distance between you.
Yeah, I mean, he's winning these rounds, but it can make them a lot clearer and a lot easier for him to get through, because let's be right, he's winning the rounds, but the hard rounds out there, and he can make it a lot easier.
He's making it hard for himself, and they're very competitive, but he's giving his opponent chances, you know what I mean? You don't want to be in range and taking the big shots, which he's taking at the minute. He's showing a good chin at the minute, but we've all seen before and in the past, you know, no chin's granny.
Just come out behind the jab a bit more this round, which is better to see.
While they're at range now, I'd like to see him just pop it out, just kick him to occupy him and mix it up. There you go. A lot better.
Yeah, I'm liking this.
Lovely shot. You see, he's holding on now. He's being stronger coming forward, but he's grabbing on now. He wants the rest.
See how his hands have come down to protect his body now.
I'd like to see how well Muhammad can create the gap now to see if he can land that shot again. Yeah. This is all about dressing up, disguising the shot.
Yep.
Maybe tap the head first and then bang the body. He just landed low there, well spotted by the referee.
He's looking for the body now.
He's just hurt him with a body shot, so he's gonna try, obviously, to try and land in the same spot again. But you're only doing that by maybe either tapping the head first or, you know, creating the gap for the shot.
You know, sometimes when you're watching boxing and someone goes down off a body shot, you know, some fans don't understand that, how debilitating that can be, but they can really freeze you up, can't they?
Yeah, when you get hit by a body shot, it just takes the wind out of you, and believe me, your elbows go right into where that spot is. You don't want to be it again, so it's not so easy as people think just to go and land in the same spot again. You know, he's definitely guarding it, and Jack points out right away how soft his elbow straight went down, and he wasn't too fussed about getting it at the head, but he didn't want to get it in the body again.
One thing about the body shots is they're so hard to recover from. Yeah. You know, you can have the best chin in the world, if you get it to the body, sometimes there's no way back from them.
That's a good shot from Ali, and Softus just before that threw an absolutely massive right hook which went over the top.
Yeah.
But they are still swinging away, and so is, and Softus is he looks like he's got the bit between his teeth at the minute.
Yeah, I think he's got his breath back now.
Oof, he's loading up on these.
That's much better from Muhammad Ali, though. That jab's working nicely now.
Yeah. That's what you guys were calling for.
Yeah, I think in round one or two, when Softus was swinging these big shots, Ali was tucking up and going in the shell and then firing back, and he was gambling, you know, he was taking chances, whereas, you know, Jack was calling for him to get on his jab, and he's just been doing it then and showing what he can do, and that's where the skill comes in, and you know, the well-schooled boxer comes into it, and he's doing it now.
Really nice
now. He's keeping his range, he's using his jab, and he's making his opponent miss.
I think them body shots he's been investing in as well has taken a bit out of Softus, and he looks to be not on the back foot, but he's definitely not throwing as many swings as he once was.
Yeah, he's got a little few distress singles on his face, hasn't he?
Yeah.
Good round.
And I tell you something, Jack the matchmaker here is he's giving everyone a bit of a test anyway, which is good. Yeah. That's what we want to see.
So you get the paying public coming back. If you see a good shot, if you see a 2-1 side, then you probably give the next one a miss. Whereas come to any of these shows and they're going to be going home happy and coming back again.
It's a brilliant fight so far.
Yeah, really good. And of course, you guys get to watch it all for free on BBTV. We're really grateful that you've joined us. Big thank you from all of us over here. It's GSW's Maiden Professional Boxing Show. To round number five, Muhammad Ali, the diabetic kid, Mykhailo Softus, and it's been a good little scrap. This, some big shots going in. Just get the feeling there's going to be one more little sting in the tail somewhere, big exchange somewhere.
Yeah, it's an exciting fight, and it's full of exchanges where the boat letting the hands go and the boat landing as well. To be fair to them, so you can always see something else coming. We pointed out earlier was I think the corner for Muhammad Ali might be a little bit unhappy after this fight, the fact that how much of the fight's being spent at a close range. When you're fighting a shorter opponent, you want more of the fight being at your range, at long range. So, you know, obviously if you're a shorter man, you want a lot more of the fight up close because you've got a better chance of landing. So for Muhammad being the taller fighter, I think his corner will be a little bit disappointed he spent so much time up close. But, you know, we said in round one he did try and box and he didn't have much success, so I think he may have subconsciously made the decision and thought, you know what, I've got to mix it up. And if it's been his own choice, then good on him.
Yeah, because you're right, he's happy now to stand there right in there in the pocket now, isn't he, with him?
Yeah, if you're letting a shorter man drag you into a fight and have to fight at his range, then it's not really good for yourself. You know, you haven't, you know, made yourself get the fight at your range, but if it's his own choice, then, you know, I'll take it back.
Yeah, he may have felt something or seen something which made him think he's better on the inside.
Yeah, I think it's still something as his corner can say to him, look, you don't do that again, you know, we make the fight our fight. But I think if he's been dragged into the fight, which credit to his opponent, you know, Softus has made the fight tough. You know, Muhammad Ali will know he's in a fight, he's been in a fight tomorrow when he wakes up, because he's took some big shots tonight. But He's also dissed him.
Muhammad Ali, he might be so used to in the gym, in sparring or wherever, you know, fighting on the inside, and he's coming here against a smaller, stockier opponent, and it's something he's not used to, so he might be having to get in there. But saying that, looking at the way he's boxing now, you know, he's quite tight on the inside now, whereas the first few rounds it was quite tip for tap, but it does look like he's a bit more clued up on the inside now, and that jab is popping in between, which is nice.
Oh, nice. Ooh,
yeah, lovely nice work there.
And got to watch them
swing. Those swinging ones, isn't it?
Yeah. It's a game opponent, honestly.
He's game. And
it's the sort of fights everyone wants to see in it, though. It is
exactly
really
that.
Testing.
No one can say he's come to legs arm. Look at that. He's swinging everything. He's got
he's
into everything.
Throwing absolutely everything into these shots.
It's great for us.
It's great to watch. He's like he's a bit like a Maidana, isn't he? Just hit whatever you can see. Just throw
it. I can think is, in my eyes, all I can see is Pitbull on the back of his shorts. And I'm thinking, you know what? He's bang on.
Yeah. So genuine, that, isn't it?
And with that said, Ali's doing well just to keep his nose in front here because.
Oh, nice shot.
Softest good shot there, body shot.
The body himself.
And a good jab back from Ali on the bell. And that was a little bit. That was a little bit naughty on after the bell. Yeah.
Yeah, he's apologised.
Fair enough, he's apologised for that and got back on with it. Yeah, it's a bit of a replay here, guys. So we've got some big swings going in.
Yeah, that was the right of the body, softest landed just at the end, and then this after the bell, we can see. It was really late. Like I think, he apologised after it. He didn't mean it, but it was very late. I wouldn't have been happy.
You wouldn't. You would definitely not have been happy.
I'd have chased him around that ring.
Yeah, the pit bull soaked it, and he went straight out to his corner.
And if it happened to Liam, that would have been it. Pandemonium.
He threw him out the ring, I think.
Having said that, everyone says Liam's the most hot-headed one out of the brothers. Is that actually true?
Oh, yeah. I don't think you need me to tell you that. Liam would argue with himself in an empty room.
No, I get scared going to ask him for an interview, so I just sort of like hover around until someone else gets him.
No, honestly. Liam's been that way since he was a kid. He'd argue with himself, honestly.
So it's been an entertaining scrap. We're moving into the sixth round now.
I've enjoyed this, and you know what? I'm liking the way that Muhammad Ali has adapted to this fight, and he's changed his tactics round by round, and I do like how he's throwing his straight shots now, and you know, he's coming out on top.
Yeah, he's trying to create a bit more distance with the straighter shots, but he is learning on the job. It is a great learning fight for him, which will put him in good stead going forward.
And he landed some good clean shots here, Ali, in this round.
He's in with a live opponent, let me tell you.
Oh God, he's live. He is live.
He is.
Oh, that's a good left hook. That could be one of the best shots of the fight, actually, that left hook. It momentarily puts Softus on the back foot, which we have not seen a lot in this fight. Some exchanges going in here.
Tell you what, he's really taking it to him now.
No one can say they're not leaving it all in there either. Both fights are really going for it. Everything's every shot.
Loading up.
There's lovely shot.
Two game lads in there. I mean, it's making for a real spectacle.
It really is. And you know what? Them body shots are really taking the toll now.
I think he might be starting to get to something.
He
can feel it, can't he? I think he feels he's really on top here. And that's a good right hand. And you know, Steve's having a real close
look
at him here.
The body shots are paying off here.
They are.
He's landing clean to the air from them. I think Softus is worried about getting it downstairs again, so that the headshots are landing a little bit easier.
He's really turned this around, hasn't he, in sense of momentum-wise?
Yeah.
Which does suggest, I mean, I know it's not over yet, of course it's not, but it does suggest that, you know, the longer distance fights, he's going to be coming on strong.
Softus is really feeling it now. You can see him, he's blowing blood. So it's
he's looking marked up,
work.
Isn't he? Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what? If he gets his first stop with Jim Muhammad Ali, then he's definitely earned it.
He has.
Yeah. Yeah.
but you can't write soft to
you,
soft.
You can't write him off because
while he's swinging from the floor, you can't write him off.
You just can't.
Their body shots are nice.
Oh,
that one bad.
I felt that one from here.
Tell you what, fair play.
Tell you what,
lads,
take your hat off. Take that your hat off to these two
brilliant.
Lads.
Absolutely brilliant.
Really, really good.
Both lads earned the money there, Jack, didn't
they? I proper enjoyed that. That was a great fight.
Seeing some of the action back here, they were both throwing everything they had.
You know what though? Fair play to Ahmed Ali because he put it on him a bit, and in that last round he could have easily just got on his back foot and moved, but he thought, you know what, I'm going to take it to him. And at one point I thought he was going to get him out of there.
He started taking over, didn't he? Yeah,
he did.
Yeah, he nearly did. And as you said, he was ahead in the fight, so he could have been forgiven for moving.
Oh, Ali just saying here that Steve's his bad luck charm because he can't get a stoppage when Steve's here. He was on the verge of one then, but
it was close.
You've got to take it out after softest as well because he's a tough little pit bull.
So yeah he's in with a Steve, you're not allowed to anymore.
That's
of,
it, Steve.
Marvin Ali.
Well, we actually like you here, so I think we might actually just have to pull rank.
That was his best performance as well. Then I'm not coming no more.
We're going to go to the MC for the official confirmation.
Please.
A well-deserved win there from Muhammad Ali.
What a fight we have just witnessed.
Right.
Fantastic performance.
Drew,
just sum it up
the,
for me.
Interview
it was a great
Muhammad
performance.
Ali.
I boxed 6 weeks ago, so he was a tough, tough lad, you know, compared to the last opponent. And another learning lesson, I've created history once becoming the first diabetic boxer, and I want to go on to create history again by becoming the first diabetic champion. And with learning fights such as that, is going to lead me onto that mission to conquer it, hopefully, all being well.
Yeah, I mean, 6 valuable rounds there. A very, very tough, durable opponent in there. It looked like you hurt him to the body and then you were targeting it. Do you feel that was having the most effect?
Yeah, absolutely. He was just a tough, tough man who weathered the storm. You know, each time I hurt him, he weathered the storm and came back with something, you know, himself. So credit to him. You know, at least I showed that I can consume a shot as well. And all being well, the future's bright. You know, I hope, you know, the fans, in, you know, the viewers at home, because the fans inside the building absolutely enjoyed it. But I hope everyone at home enjoyed the bout.
I'm pretty sure everyone did. It was brilliant. You've now had 5-6 rounders. Are you looking to step up, get to, you know, more rounds under your belt? It looked like you actually got better, more momentum as the fight went on.
Yeah. This was my last final 6 rounder. We were talking about it upstairs. And all being well, my next fight will be an 8 rounder. You know, let's keep learning. Do you know, this is school for me. Do you know, learning in the boxing gym at home. I didn't get to box for 3 years, you know, from 2015 to 18. Because due to my diabetes. And then during COVID, I had another halt for 2.5 years. And now we're getting building momentum. And let's get the ball rolling, you know. Create history again, like I keep repeating myself. You know, coming lower in the weights as well, you know, at welterweight. That's the target.
Are we going to see another quick turnaround in your next fight, or are you going to have a bit of time off?
No time off. I've got no time on my hands. I want to keep busy. I've got great sponsors and, you know, all the diabetes community out there, you know, cheering me on. and I hope they start coming out in the numbers, you know, to the arenas and purchasing tickets, you know, via my social links and via the promoters. That's the plan.
Well, it was a fantastic win and a great fight from both of you. Well,
can I say that, you know, my coaches at Oliver's, you know, put in a hell of a shift with me, you know, Humphrey Harrison, and on Sunday, on Thursday, you can tell I consumed some shots in there. On Thursday, it's Thomas's birthday, and I want to wish him a big, big happy birthday. I can't wait for our Japanese we're going for, you know, all the lads. Can't wait to jump in. And, you know, all my sponsors are here as well, and, you know, I want to thank them, you know, massively for their support. Onwards and upwards we go.
Well done. Enjoy that.
Thank you so much. Thank you, guys.
Well, a fantastic fight we just saw there. We're going to keep the action coming, so we're going to hand you back to your ringside team.